power consumer on the vehicle, because it's running all day, because it's hot as hell.
You've got to have that on board, baby. That goes everywhere, you never know. What's with the focus?
And there's the dash. It's a pretty basic old dash, you know. Doesn't look like anything's been refurbed. It's got the tilt. Kick it down. Kick it up. I'm loving that. And I love how these seats, these bucket seats, spin like that. You know, you tip it forward, you know, you tip it just like that when you're getting into it. You just roll up on your step, sit on in, give it a spin, and you're locked in. Got to get out. Simple. Spin. Just hop straight out. I love it. Those seats rock. And they come out, too. I unbolt those. Once we're settled in, these four bolts here, real, you know, typical. Undo the bolts, and then I bring the seats out and sit them next to the reservoir, river, next to the side of the vehicle, you know, wherever I want them. And it makes a lot more room inside for the dogs. So, loving that. This is my bank, all right? This is where I keep all of the 12-volt batteries that run pretty much everything in the cab. The batteries, these are two golf cart batteries, just like I've got in my home system. A pair of these 6-volt batteries wired together. I get 220 amp hours out of this right here, so that is more than enough with the panels up on the roof for some good storage. But if there, you know, there's enough room here. I keep, you know, miscellaneous stuff in here, some cables, in case I need to, you know, there's enough room in there to double your bank. I get 440 amp hours storage in this thing, and dude, that's plenty. I mean, that's a ton of storage. So there's three ways from this vehicle to charge your bank, your batteries. Three ways. The first way to charge this bank is run the vehicle. When your vehicle's driving, you're charging your bank. The second way to charge your bank is plug in your landline. You pull this out, plug into shore power, it's a 30-foot cord, then that will be charging your bank. Plug that landline also into, you know, a generator, most common. And then, third and foremost, and most exciting of all, is sit in the sun. We'll charge your bank. And I'm talking 9 amps charging your bank. Loving it. And I've taken this thing everywhere. Well, not everywhere, but I use it a lot. I haven't done anything to it. I've almost had it a year now. Almost a year. And I've been many a camp. And I haven't done anything to it but add oil. I had a little exhaust problem down there. Woohoo. Big deal. Nothing but a quick welder can't fix. And, dude, I love this thing. Instant fishing tackle access is a must. You've got to have quick access to hooks, a place to take them, and a place to put them. We like to fish right out of the back of this thing. This flag is already on the vehicle. That rocks. The vehicle has three water tanks. One fresh water tank up underneath the couch that I already showed you. And then two spill tanks. Two excess tanks that are under the vehicle. One tank for black water. That's your sewage. Got nothing but. And the other tank is gray water. Which is shower and what comes out of your sink, your dishes. So you just, you know, bam, you just pull the old deals. And I'm not going to pull it. I don't know if I'm loaded. I use it quite a bit. I might have something up in there. Well, gray water won't kill me. Yeah, there's a little gray water. Yeah, I better take care of that. This looks, appear to be... have some stuff in there. So that's how that works. Pretty awesome. Oh, and there's, you know, there's tubes and whatnot. The store down here. In here we've got the, you know, toolbox, duct tape, tire wrench, and those sewage tubes for clean exit of the toxins. You know, you don't want to get any of that around the old gas station pump out. It's also got these cool lights up on the roof that work all awesome. You know, they tip around,
when they splash up on this red velvet at night, it's all ambiance style.
There's four of them. And I don't know what's with the focus on this thing, but they're pretty cool. Awesome leather interior. Looks like new windows, except the cab. The cab's drafty. And it's, you know, some storage up underneath. It also has this velvet-looking blanket that stores up here. And that blanket's got snaps on it that snap into these snaps right here along this, boy, that focus is just terrible. In other words, it hangs, it's a carpet, a blanket that goes all the way around the windows, and it just easily snaps on, goes up underneath the steering wheel. So you can be in here with these drapes closed. There's drapes on the back, a little pull down, drapes on the side, drapes all the way around. Punchline? Yeah, you're private. Feel free to walk around in your boxer shorts. You know what I'm saying? You're covered. You're good there. And I love that. Because there's something about walking around in boxer shorts in the woods. You know what I'm saying? Huh? There's another one over here on the window. Way sweet. You gotta love the dually effect. It's also got, just as you hop up into it, it's not much, but if you lift the old, the lid, you know, it's not a deep thing. I don't know why that's there. It stores flat things, you know. Got a little saw, skillet, some wood I use for the solar panel positioning. Some garbage bags, and there's some room for some other stuff, so that's pretty cool.
This is a pretty handy little item on the side of the RV. One of those is to drain your water from your fresh water tank. The other one, there's a wire hooked up to it that goes to a pump. You got a wire up front and next to my battery. You hook it up to the positive, and now this thing draws fuel from your main gas tank. I'm presuming to fill generators, I'm guessing, and, you know, draw a few gallons out to start a big fire or hook someone up with a gallon or two that's out of fuel. Real easy. I love it.
Yeah, batteries are full. See, we're only coming in at 3.5 amps because I just used the batteries for the water and a couple other things. So it'll top off real quick and this light will start flashing. And just basically keep your batteries in float. Keep them just topped off and ready to go.
And it's also got a sweet closet here. It's pretty deep, you know. Deep storage for whatever else, all your stuff. Looks like it's already got a CB antenna on it. That's pretty sweet. All I need is a CB. Right there, that's perfect. I'll bolt the CB right there on the roof. Roof doesn't look too bad. Looks like it might be able to use a little love, but for the most part, it's right. This is pretty sweet. This holds your door open. Huh? You guys are gonna love this. Check this out. Cool. Anyway, that's it. Well, that does it for me. That's about everything in it. 1979 Dodge Sportsman. Go out and get one. And get out there and rock. See ya.
Now when this is over, over and through, and all them changes have come and passed, I wanna meet you in the big sky country. I just wanna prove, mama, love can last.